What's up guys, Fi here, welcome back to the channel. So today I've got another card game for you. This one is probably the card game that I've been playing for the longest amount of time. I learned it when I was very young, maybe like 8 or 9 years old, so I've been playing it for about 17 years. It's a very fun game, it's very easy to learn. It's called Warlords and Scumbags. You might have played a similar game, might go by a different name, but I will teach you the version that I know, the rules that I've been playing my whole life, and let's jump into it. So how you play Warlords and Scumbags, you can play with at least 3 people. There's basically no limit. It gets pretty ridiculous if you're playing with like 12 people or something, but you can play with between like 3 and 8 and the game will work very well. So to play Warlords and Scumbags, you need a regular deck with 52 cards, plus 2 jokers. So include the 2 jokers in the deck. So then you just deal out all of the cards to the players. So then after you've dealt the cards, everyone sorts their hands and you're again hiding your hand from your opponents. So the power level of the cards, the Joker is the most powerful card, and then 2 is the next powerful, and then it just goes normally from Ace down to 3. So 3 is the weakest card. So I'll just sort all of the hands now. Okay, I've sorted all the hands now. So you just basically have the Joker, your highest cards to the left and your lowest cards to the right. And it doesn't matter about the suits. Suits are basically completely irrelevant in this game. So the person who starts is the person with the 3 of spades. So that is this person. When you lead, so when you start the pile of cards in the middle, you basically just want to play your lowest cards and as many of the same number as you have. So for example, this person has the 3 of spades and they also have the 3 of clubs, so they will play both 3s out into the middle pile, and that's their turn finished. So they've played the 2 3s, and because they led with 2, everyone now has to put, oh sorry, the next person now has to put 2 cards on top, like a pair that's higher than 3. So basically, looking at their hand, they've got these 2 sevens. They can't play any of these on top because they're not pairs, but they have these 2 sevens, so they can play the 2 sevens on top of the 2 threes. Yep. And they just put them out there like that. So play just goes around clockwise. If you can't beat the cards that are out here, or if you don't want to, you pass. So for example, this person has 3 jacks. Maybe they don't want to break up their 3 jacks. Maybe they want to keep them all together. And maybe they didn't have these 2 queens. So maybe this person would pass. And that's okay. So they just don't do anything this round. And then it would just keep going around. And when somebody has... okay, we've got 4 people. So when 3 people have passed in a round, the entire middle pile gets turned over. And the person who had the cards on top leads. So I'll just keep playing so you can see. So this person would probably play their 2 queens. Yep. Just put the queens on. This person has 2 twos, which are very powerful. So they might have a bit of a decision now. If they want to use the 2 twos here, and I think most people would, I would. So there's a bit of strategy in this game. You have to decide if you want to hold on to your powerful cards or if you want to use them up now, because the entire goal is to get rid of your entire hand. So eventually you want to play them, but usually you want to play them when you think you will win and everyone else will pass, so then you can lead and play your lower cards. How the jokers work are you can play 1 joker on anything and it wins. Nothing can beat a joker. A joker doesn't beat a joker. You have to play a higher card. So if you play a joker, the whole pile just gets turned over. So this person played 2 twos. The only thing that can be played on top is a joker. So going around, this person has a joker. Let's just say that they play it. They decide to play their joker on top, and that pile is finished. So we can pick up all of these cards and turn them over. So because this person sort of won that round, they cleared the pile, they get to lead. So they just pick up their 4 and put it out there. So now there was only 1 card played. So now everyone can only play 1 card on top. So this person would play their 5. This person would play their 6. So you want to be playing your lowest card that is higher than what's out there. The lowest card that you can play. Okay, now this person has a bit of a decision to make. They've got 2 eights, 2 nines, 2 tens, and a jack. I would probably play the jack. You can also make a case for playing an 8 instead and saving your jack, although the jack isn't that strong. So maybe if it was a 2, I would probably play the 8 and save the 2. But usually it's better to keep your pairs together and not split them up, because you can play them together. You can play them in one turn. Whereas if you play one now, then you have to spend another turn later playing the other one. So let's say that person played the jack. This guy has a very difficult decision as well. If he wants to play a king or an ace, I think this person would just pass, because the king and the ace won't win. So they will just be throwing a king or an ace out there, and someone else will be able to play an ace or a two or a joker on top. So they won't win and be able to play one of these cards. So this person would probably just pass. This person would probably put their king out and not split up their queens. And this person would probably play their two. Knowing that there's another joker out there though, maybe it's better to save the two. So maybe this person would pass. So these two people have passed, and this person played the king, I think. And this person will play the ace. And now it's over to this guy, because that person passed. I hope I'm not stuffing this up. But if you pass in a round, you can't come back in. You can't pass and then later play on the same pile of cards. Once you've passed, that's it for that pile. Maybe this person would play their two. And this guy would finish it off with their joker. And then the pile gets picked up and just put into the discard pile. So because this person won that round, they get to lead. And look at this, they get to play their three fours. So now people have to play three of a kind on top that's higher than four. This person has to pass. This person has to pass. And this guy here has three jacks. So let's play the three jacks on top. So he played that. This person can't beat the three jacks. They've only got pairs. So that's that pile finished. Goes over to the discard pile. The guy who played the three jacks gets to lead, and he gets to put out his three. So play just continues around clockwise. Someone leads whatever number of cards that they lead. That's how many cards you have to play on top, and you have to play higher. You can't play the same. And yeah, the goal is just to get rid of your cards as fast as possible. So I will just finish this game off, and then I'll tell you what happens at the end of the game. Okay, so this person just won the last round, and they get to lead, so they get to play out their eight, and they've won the game. So they become the warlord for this round, and play continues. So this person went out, and this person gets to play now. And play will continue until there's one person left, and they are the scumbag. And I'll tell you what happens when we get to that stage. Okay, so this is the end of the game. This person just played two nines. This guy can play his two aces on top. And this person has to pass. Oh, I don't know what happened there. There should be two aces on top. So this person has to pass. They only have two tens. So the pile gets flipped over. And this person is out. They play their two sixes. And this person, who happens to be me, is the scumbag. So then at the end of the round, you have a warlord and a scumbag. All of the cards just get put back into the pile. Once the game's finished, you just bring all the cards back together, shuffle them, and deal again. So let's do that. And deal out all the cards again. So then, I don't really remember who was the warlord, but when you're playing, obviously you'll remember. But let's say this person was the warlord and I was the scumbag. The warlord gives the scumbag their three lowest cards, and the scumbag gives the warlord their three highest cards. So if you become the scumbag, you're fighting, trying to get off that position. And if you are the warlord, you're fighting to try and keep that position, because yeah, the warlord has it good. They get rid of their three bad cards and they get three good cards from the scumbag. And it's a little bit of fun joking about people who, yeah, can't get off scumbag, basically. So I'll just quickly show you how that works. So I'll just sort these two hands. Okay, so the scumbag has to take their three most powerful cards. So basically just the three cards on the left of their hand, if they sort their hand like I do. So they just take the three highest cards and pass them over here. And the warlord takes their three lowest cards. So this 6, 4, and 3. And they don't get to decide which cards they want to pass. Like perhaps this person would rather pass a 7 than a 6. because they want to keep their pair because they can play it in the same turn, but they must pass their three lowest. So they pass it like this, and then you just sort the hand again. So now you can see how much more powerful the Warlord's hand is. They've got jokers, twos, aces, king, and their lowest card is a six. And, oops, the poor scumbag has to pick up their cards off the floor. The scumbag has king as their highest card. And, yeah, what can happen is that the scumbag ends up with a lot of low cards like this, so they can play these all together. They can play like three threes or something. But usually it's quite difficult to get off that scumbag position and become a regular player or a warlord again. So yes, that is how Warlords and Scumbags works. There's not that much strategy to it. You have to make some decisions about whether you want to split up your pairs and triples and whatnot, but it's just a very good, simple game, good fun to play, and you can play with quite a few people. And yeah, it's been a big part of my childhood, so I'm quite fond of this game. So I hope you guys try out this game. I hope you like it. Let me know in the comments section if you do. And also let me know if I put up any videos and you've played a similar version of a game, or it's called a different name or something. I'd love to read those comments, and you can tell me if there's any rules that you play which that I don't play that would make the game even better. Please tell me, and I'd love to know. So yeah, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.